Hello, everyone. I hope everybody's having a wonderful day today. It is a beautiful day, right? Thursday already, you know? Look at that, y'all. We almost at Friday. Before I start, I want to share the gospel first. It is found in 1 Corinthians 15, 1 through 4. Jesus Christ died for our sins, was buried, and on the third day rose from the dead according to scriptures for our justification. Jesus, the only begotten Son of God, always existed, left glory, laid down his glory, was born of a virgin, wrapped himself in flesh, lived a perfect life without sin, went to that cross and shed his precious blood for the remission of all our sins, past, present, and future. And what Jesus calls is that we believe in his gospel for our salvation. One of the main purposes wasn't just to die for our sins, but also to reconcile us back to God, you know? Because sin separated us from God. When Adam sinned, sin entered into the world. This is why everyone that is born into sin automatically, every single person, except Christ. Because Christ did not come from the seed of a man. It was a virgin, miraculous birth, okay? That's what makes him unique, where he did not inherit this sinful nature. That's why he was without sin, okay? But he became sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him, for those who believe, okay? Jesus died for everyone. And what you must understand is, you are a sinner. Every single person have sinned against God. Everyone. No one is exempt. So if someone's saying, well, I don't sin, that's a lie. Everyone has sinned against God. Excuse me. And what needs to happen is you need to come to the end of yourself and realize that you are a sinner in need of a savior. And this is why it's so important, because people are dying every single day, you know? And if you die today, people are still talking about the rapture, but let me tell you something. If you die today without being born again, you will end up in hell. And hell is a literal place. It's not an imagination. It is a physical dwelling place, a place of everlasting torment, where there'll be weeping and gnashing of teeth, okay? Where the worms do not die. So this is all coming from Jesus himself, okay? He taught more about hell. Just want to warn people. People are going there. You don't have to go there, okay? If you end up in hell, it is your fault. You have no one to blame. Because you know what? Jesus has made it so simple. And all he's asking is believe on his finished redemptive work. Because the bottom line is this. The Bible tells us that the wages of sin is death. But the good news is the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. That is what you want. He is offering us a free gift for what he has already done and accomplished. Okay. He paid for our sin debt, all of it, past, present, and future. And he's offering it as a gift to us for those who will receive it and be thankful about it. Instead, excuse me, you got people today, you give them the gospel, they reject it because it's too simple. It's too simple, really. Well, guess what? We have nothing to do with the gospel. It's always been about Jesus. He established how he wants people to get saved, and that is by believing, okay? There is no addition to the gospel. People will say we need to be baptized. Baptism is not a requirement for salvation. However, baptism is a good thing, you know? It's just an outward expression of an inward reality of what you already have, okay? You don't get baptized to get saved. You get baptized because you are saved already, okay? If you don't get baptized, it doesn't make a difference, you know? You're still going to heaven as long as you are saved. You see, the baptism that the Bible teaches us verbatim, that's requirement for salvation, is the baptism of the Holy Spirit, which is what occurs at the time of believing and fully being persuaded in the gospel of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. This is when the Holy Spirit comes and indwells in a believer at that point, okay? This happens the moment you believe, that nanosecond you have come to trust Jesus Christ and you believe God in his account concerning his son and his finished redemptive work on the cross, saved, sealed, sanctified. you were sealed by the Holy Spirit of promise until the day of redemption. Okay? And I want to bring something to you guys. So please, if you're not saved, you need to get saved right now. The rapture is imminent, okay? But at the same time, people are dying every day, y'all. So some people might not even see the rapture. Hey, sad to say, but some people won't, you know? Who knows? It can happen today, but guess what's going to happen today for sure? People are going to be dying. That's for sure. How many of those people are saved? How many are not saved? Don't know. But I want you to understand, people are waking up in eternity. Either eternity with God or eternity separate from God. You don't want to be separate from God, because everything in hell is exactly everything that's opposite of who God is, His nature. You know, all the good things is with God, and because hell was not created for humans, it was actually created for Satan, you know, and his angels, okay? All those fallen angels, the demons, all of them, they were all created for them. But guess what? When you reject God, there's only one place you can go, and that is hell. Because you reject the one who wants you to spend eternity with him. Well, if you reject him, say, well, I don't want nothing to do with you. Well, the only other place, because you're not going to be roaming around anywhere. The only other place to go is there's only two destinations, heaven or hell. You reject Christ, you end up in hell. You accept the free gift of salvation. Okay? You make it in. You know, when people say, well, what does it mean? Well, if you ever told a lie anything in your life at all, you already sinned. Babies do tell lies, but you know what? Babies are not held accountable until the age of accountability. What is that age? Don't know, you know? Personally, I think, just my opinion on this one, because the Bible doesn't tell you what that age is, but I think it has to do with age of puberty. That's what I'm thinking. You know, when a person reaches puberty, then that maybe they become accountable. Man, I could be wrong on that. You know, I don't know, you know, but that's not important. What's important is that we all are born into sin and we all need a savior. Okay. Excuse me. We all need a savior. And his name is Jesus Christ. And he is calling all men to himself to repent. That means to change your mind from your unbelief and to believe on the finished redemptive work. Believe on the account that God gave concerning him. Okay. If you could trust Jesus today and fully be persuaded within yourself that Jesus is Lord indeed, okay, and that he died on that cross for and shed his precious blood, which is sufficient to pay for all your sins, past, present, and future. If you believe it today, you are saved. That is his promise, okay? The apostles taught this. Jesus himself taught this, okay? Read the book of John. I don't know how many times Jesus was saying, yeah, people still argue. Look, man. No amount of works is going to get you into heaven. Keeping the law is dead works. I'm going to tell you that. That puts you right back. And if you're keeping count of sins, guess what that means? You're back under the law. Because sin is transgression of the law. And guess what? The law brings you knowledge of sin. You get it? So it's all linked. We're not under the law. We're under the grace, dispensation of grace. And in this dispensation of grace, we are saved by grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone. Ephesians 2:8-9 is so simple. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a gift of God, not by works, lest any man should boast. You need to believe the gospel today like your life depends on it. Seriously, because your life does depend on it. Your eternity, per se. Okay? You don't want to be caught off guard, man. The rapture is imminent. There's a video I'm going to link here. I found this video pretty awesome. So please enjoy the video. And I hope to God that you please heed this warning and trust Jesus Christ today. Time is running out, y'all. There's so much things going on right now, and I can't even get into it because some is kind of depressing and some is just exciting. But for me, each time I see all this stuff, there's an excitement inside because that means we're going home. And that's exactly what Jesus told us. When you see these things, look up and rejoice, for your redemption draws nigh. Do you understand me? So we are going home, y'all. I mean, it's just a matter of when, but we know that when is approaching. Okay. I hope it happens sooner. I hope it just happens sooner than most people think. But, yeah, people, please believe the gospel today. All right. Love you all as always, and thank you for all those who subscribe to my channel. And, you know, I know I do some live. Sadly, yesterday live was a little bit messed up because while I was at the Target parking lot, somehow I just keep getting disconnected, even though I have full bars, which makes no sense. And I wasn't seeing, you know, new comments and stuff that people were trying to write. So I'm like, whatever. So it's kind of like, it kind of just threw me off, you know, a bit, but it is what it is. But anyway, as always, you guys just keep living for Christ, okay? Remember who you are in Christ. You are complete in Christ, lacking nothing, okay? You just have to remember that all you need, you already have it. All you have to do is acknowledge that you already have what you need and thank God for it, okay? Because God is one that's in control. And if he's in control, we ought to be thanking him every day and be excited knowing that whatever we need, he got us covered. But we got to thank him for it, okay? Let us not be in a mindset of, oh, I don't have. No. What we have, we already got what we need. I mean, Jesus himself, you know, told that to us, you know? You know, if we can give good gifts to our kids, you know, our Heavenly Father, how much more our Heavenly Father, you know? And we're supposed to be evil people. How much more our Heavenly Father, which is good, where he takes care of us, man. I know that for a fact, you know? So, please keep your eyes on Jesus, you know? Don't lose hope. You know, I know some people are depressed because they just want this rapture to happen already. There's too much going on. Some people are in a far worse situation than others. We're not promised that we won't, you know, have any of that. You know what I'm saying? So that's a form of trial, tribulation, whatever you want to call it. But that's not the tribulation, the time of Jacob's trouble, obviously, you know? So just keep in mind, soon and very soon, all this will be over, okay? And you won't have to worry about ever being down again, ever being sad, anxiety, fear, depression, none of that would exist again in us, okay? So just hang on. We are almost there. We are the finish line, y'all. Just hang on. Eyes on Jesus, okay? Enjoy the video. Peace.